Today we're going to look again at the RC24 Mini and the Compact Flash CPM add-on card. So now that you have put it together, what can you actually do with it? How can you access the CPM on the disk? We're going to download a copy of Microsoft Basic, put it on the disk, and access the disk from inside there. Here we are in the small computer monitor. From here, we have several choices. We can work within the small computer monitor itself. We can go into Basic. We can warm start Basic, or we can go into CPM. If we attempt to start Basic itself, which runs from the ROM, we're now inside Basic. So let's write a short program. We can list our program, and we can execute our program. However, if we try to save the application to our flashcard, it will not allow us to do so. In order to run Basic and also to access our CPM system, we need to run Basic from the disk. So to get back into the monitor, we just type monitor. So from here, we can jump into CPM. On the compact flash card, there are a number of volumes. As the compact flash card is 64 megabytes and CPM supports a maximum of an 8 megabyte volume, there have to be a number of volumes on this card. Keying in the dir command will give you a list of the files on that volume. CPM does not have the concept of folders or directories on a volume, so everything is in the root of the volume. So in this A drive, we have a single application, which is the download.com. On the B drive, we have nothing. On the C drive, we have a number of other utilities which are part of CPM. So how do we get Basic, our application we wish to use, onto the CPM system? Well, for that, we need to go onto our website and we need to pull down a version of Microsoft Basic. There are a number of sites that actually support CPM, and this is one of them. This gives you a number of CPM applications which you can actually download to your computer, as well as a couple of utilities that are very useful. We have Basic as it existed in 1981, Microsoft Basic as it existed in 1985, and there is also a version of BBC Basic. When clicking on these links, it will download a packaged file. If we have a look at the packaged file in Notepad, we'll see at the very start of this file, it has a command, a download, which is going to execute the download application on the A drive of your CPM system. It's then going to create a file called mbasic85.com. It will use the user zero area of CPM, which is basically accessible to all users. It's then followed by a hexadecimal listing of the code itself. And at the very bottom of our hex listing is a checksum. So how do we get this file into our RC24 CPM system? Well, simply select all the text in the document, do a copy, and then pop back to TeraTerm. I'm going to go into the F drive, which at the moment has no files in it. If we do a right click, we'll get a pop-up window telling us the current contents of the clipboard. So since we're on the F drive, this is going to take this hexadecimal listing and create it as the mbasic85.com file on your F drive. If we hit OK on that, we'll see it's now started executing the download program. This download program will then start showing a progress, a series of dots on the screen. However, be prepared for a wait. This harks back to the days when downloads were at modem speeds as opposed to broadband speeds. And here we have the application finally downloaded. So having downloaded MBasic85, let's try executing it. There's our application. And now we're inside MBasic 85. So let's write a short application. And let's try executing it. So can we save this to disk? So it appears to save to disk, so let's go back to CPM and have a look. And there is our application. So just to prove it still works, let's go back into MBasic and load it back up again. So we currently have no program in memory. And we have now loaded our application. So we can now load and save from inside BASIC, giving us the full functionality of the CPM disk. Although MBasic 85 does date back to 1985, it does have some very useful features. This version of BASIC is a line number BASIC, which means each command has its own line number to indicate the order in which the commands are actually executed. If you find you need to insert code into places where you're running out of line numbers, you can use the renumber command. The renumber command takes three optional parameters. The first is the new number you wish your program to start at. So let's say 100. Then the number at which you want to start renumbering, let's say 10, and the increment. Let's say we're going to step each command by 50. Now we do a list. Our program is still exactly the same and will still execute in the same order, but the line numbers on each command are now starting at 100 and incrementing by 50 for each command. There is also a very useful auto command. The auto command has two parameters. One to say which line number you wish to begin at, and the second to say what your increment is going to be. The default for the increment is 1. So let's say we want 100 for 50. It will then attempt to start your code at 100. To get out of the auto renumbering, you need to do a Control C. And if we list our application now, we will see it has effectively put the numbers in for you. This saves a lot of typing when you're keying in a lot of code. I'll put links in the description below to a few sites you may find useful, either from MBasic or for CPM itself. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.